Got to Auckland, got to my hotel. It's quite a nice hotel, so I'm here for two nights. It's quite a large bathroom. It feels like today I haven't really done much, because pretty much after I woke up, I went straight to the airport, but I didn't really have a lot of time, and I was kind of hanging around the airport for quite a while. And then obviously, about a 3 hour flight, and then 2 hours into the future. So I've kind of lost a day today. All I've had today is a burger at the airport, so I'm hungry. I was hoping maybe I could get some food from somewhere. So it's 10 to 6 in the morning. I'm just waiting outside my hotel in Auckland to be picked up for the Hobbiton and the Glowworm Cave tour. So it's supposed to be about 6 o'clock, so it's good to make sure I'm ready early just in case. I can't see it here just yet, so I am pretty tired. I think I might sleep on the coach, like a coach or a little taxi, I don't know what it is. So I'm just at the Shire's Rest, which is just before we actually go through to the actual movie set of Hobbiton. So now in the Green Dragon Inn in Hobbiton. The tour was pretty cool. I think one of the best things I've done so far in the last couple of weeks. It's really cool in here. I've currently got a local beer, Hobbit beer, which I can't remember what it's called now, but it's quite nice. So whilst on the tour bus on the way back to my hotel, I saw a pub. By the Ted's Pub, which I wasn't really expecting to find in Auckland, if anywhere, but I went in there for a beer anyway, so it was okay. It wasn't, I was kind of thinking it might have like pictures of Father Ted and Dougal and Jack and that, but no, nothing like that in there. It was just, I think it's just a name. So I just spent like 45 minutes queuing up for Ferg Burger because I still can't check in yet. Hopefully I can now, so I'm going to head back to our store. Unfortunately, my Milford Sound flight has been cancelled because of the weather. To be honest, the weather looks fine now. So I have had an email and they've asked if I can do the highlight tour. So whether or not the highlight tour would be today or tomorrow, I'm not sure. I say it's 4 o'clock. It's about 2 hours. But I don't know, because I've still got other things that I want to do here. So today I was going to try and climb Queen Town Hill, called downhill. And tomorrow I was thinking about doing a little gym after my Lord of the Rings tour. So I'm going to check in now and sort myself out and figure out what I'm going to do. So let's check out Bird Burger. What is it like? Was it worth queuing up like 40 odd minutes for this? Actually, it looks quite good. I'm going to have to take out the tomatoes though. So that probably was the best burger, best takeaway burger I've ever had. On par with ones in restaurants? Yeah, probably. Maybe better than quite a lot. On par with some other ones. I'm not going to bother doing Milford Sound because as much as I'd love to do it, they're saying if it's 4 o'clock today, that's like the rest of my day taken up because I haven't got enough time to do anything now between that time. So I'm at the start of the Queenstown Hill walking or walkway. It doesn't look too bad. I have broken out of sweat getting up here though because it was still very steep hills just walking up the road. So I'm hoping I can do this in an hour and then down 30 minutes, 45 minutes. Don't know. But it is quite hot and I haven't got any water with me or any food, so I haven't been prepared for this. But let's see how quick I can do it. So I've been going for about half an hour. I've made it to the Basket of Dreams here. I think I've just got to walk up that path. And a bit more to the right, and I think that should be the summit. So I made it to the top. It's quite windy up here, so I don't know if my voice is going to come out okay. But yeah, it didn't take too long, maybe 45, 50 minutes. And it's a really nice view. Nice just to sit up here and just mind the view a little bit, I think, before working my way back down, which I think I can get back down in about 30 minutes. Back down in 25 minutes, which I'm quite happy with, that's good. Back at the hostel. The tour was okay, it wasn't too bad. It was very annoying that I lost an hour, pretty much 45 minutes to an hour I lost, because the Indonesian family that I was with, I think the idea was the driver was like, oh, you know, do you want to have a quick look at the bungee jump area? I think just to show the bridge and all of that. And they're like, yeah, yeah, we want to have a look at that. I wasn't too fussed. And then they're in there, and then one of the daughters decides she wants to do zip wire. But don't do this on a tour. Do this in your own time, not my time. You're wasting my time when we're supposed to be doing a tour of the area. So she's queuing up for ages. Then the mum and the other daughter decide they also want to do the zip line. So then when the first daughter's gone, and I've still got to wait for the other two, and this is like 40-odd minutes now, then by the time they're finally back up, I think, oh, God, finally we can go. Right, and then it turns out that the dad's then queuing up to buy coffees. Well, we got free tea and coffee anyway when we had a break by the river. But he seemed to, I don't know why. It was just unbelievable. And if he was going to buy coffees, why not do it when his daughters are on a zip wire? Why do it afterwards? So, it was just ridiculous. So that did annoy me. So I lost like a quarter of my tour. I lost just hanging around waiting for them at this bloody zip wire bungee jump place. So I'm about to start Tiki Track. I think it's taking me about an hour. So it's about half. Is it half one? Maybe 2 o'clock now. I don't know what time it is. So yeah, it's 1:30. If I get up by 2:30, then I'll do some luging and maybe get something to eat up top. I'd say that the track here is deeper than Queenstown Hill, as in more rocky, so more to scramble over. So for that reason, it's a bit more enjoyable. I've only been going for 40 minutes so far. So if I get in another 5 minutes, 45 minutes at the top, which isn't bad at all. Not quite 45 minutes. I've done it in 50 minutes. So quite happy with that. I managed to do it in less than an hour, so that was my target. I think there's two tracks, there's an easy one and a more difficult one. I think you have to do the easy one before you're allowed to do the difficult one. I've got my ticket and I've got my helmet, so I'm ready to do luging. Luging was awesome. I couldn't film it because you had to have your hands on the handlebars at all times, but that was so cool. I only did the two tracks, so I did the easy track, which you have to do first, then did a difficult track. Yeah, that was awesome. So I'm in a pub called The Pig and Whistle, which is next door to where I was last night at 1876. This is much better, personally. Music's better, it's a bit more chilled. I don't mind maybe going on somewhere else later on, and I can still party with the best of them, I think. But where I went last night, it was just too hectic, not my sort of crowd. Whereas here, there's quite a mixture of people, older, younger, families. And I think there's a live band on a bit later as well. But yeah, this seems okay for now. I mean, if I get a bit bored later on, I'll move on somewhere else. So almost midnight, I thought I'd get one more Ferg burger. So I got the Ferg burger deluxe to begin with, just like the beef. And last night I got the Bambi one, which is the venison. And then now I've gone for the lamb, because I've not had any New Zealand lamb since I've been here, so I thought I'd go for the lamb. It's 8:30 in the morning, New Zealand time. I'm about to start my 35-hour trip back to Heathrow. So it's about 7:30 in the evening in the UK. So I finally made it to Ha Long Bay, which is awesome. Wow, really. I'm just waiting now at Auckland Airport, so I've got about 2 hour wait till my flight. So I'm in Bangkok. So this is going to be the last stretch of my journey. I had quite a good seat on the plane to get here. I had plenty of leg room because I was by the emergency exit, so I had loads of leg room. It was quite good. Got here an hour earlier than planned, so I've got another hour of sitting around here, but I guess that's a bit better than being on the plane, because at least I can walk around a bit. It's about 3:10 in the morning in Auckland, so it's kind of like I've been up until 3:10 at the moment. Also, it's going to be about a 14-hour flight, that's why I want to sleep through on it. I think I'm going to be absolutely exhausted otherwise. I'm quite hungry, so I've already had 2 plain meals. I'm going to have 2 more on the next flight as well, so I'm fed up with plain meals. When I get home on Sunday morning, I'm going to have a fry up, I think. 7:25 UK time. I'm pretty knackered. It's taken just over an hour to get out. Quite a long hold up at baggage claim. But I'm just on the way now to get the shuttle bus to the car park to get my lift home.